Blackstone Publishing presents Charm School by Ben Reeder. This book is read by Charlie Thurston. Michaela, Isabella, Emmett, Wyatt, and Bennett. The best group of little grand munchkins a man could ever ask for. Chapter 1. When a mortal says they want things to be fair, they really just want to win. Advice given to a young demon. Wizards aren't supposed to be whiny, but Dr. Corwin was getting close to it. I could feel Shade's shoulder shake under my arm as she snickered quietly. Wanda was carefully looking at something on the far edge of the platform, but Mom looked like she wasn't about to spare his dignity. Even with dozens of people around us on the transit platform, her expression said she was ready to lay into him. Junkyard didn't offer an opinion. He was on an adventure, which was pretty much any time he wasn't at home or Dr. C's place. Any opportunity to mark a new part of the world as his was a good thing, as far as he was concerned. "This is what I could afford," I growled in response to his latest complaint. In front of us was a teleportation platform, its triple rings dormant and upright. Around it was a series of runes, and the stone floor was inscribed with magical symbols. "Master Drayden offered to fly us up on his private jet," Dr. C said, "for free. We'd be there in a matter of hours and we'd fly in comfort." "No," I told him again. "I don't want to owe him any favors. And believe me, he'd think he was doing me a favor." Dr. C's lips pressed tight together as he looked at me. Then he nodded. "You're right about that," he said after a moment, his tone resigned. "You do know you're making it harder on yourself, though, right?" I nodded. "Yeah, I know you get sick when you teleport. I'll deal with it." "Then so will I. Again." I nodded, willing the memories of his troubles with teleportation back into the box I'd built for them. Ahead of us, a group of dwarves in gray business suits stepped onto the platform, handing tickets to the man at the opening and the waist-high railing as they passed him.
"Last call for Denver Commons, Denver Commons, transiting in 3 minutes, last call."
As he finished, a woman in a flowing green dress came bustling up with two boys trailing from each hand.
"Denver Commons, that's us,"
she said as she let go of the boys' hands and dug in her purse. Moments later, she produced three tickets and thrust them at the man. He took them and gave them a quick glance, then nodded and gestured for her to go on. She grabbed the two boys by the hand again and stepped forward.
"Mom, do we have to take the transit platform?"
one of the boys asked.
"Barry always gets sick."
The other boy was turning a little green around the edges, and the woman's eyes went wide.
"Oh, hell."
The mother spat, and rushed to the edge of the platform to grab something from a wooden box, and hustled back to her sons.
"I'm glad you reminded me."
The dwarves shuffled over a little as she returned and handed the less enthusiastic-looking boy the paper bag she'd taken from the box. The man at the edge of the railing stepped back and went to a control panel by the upright rings.
"Transiting to Denver Commons,"
he called out as he manipulated the levers on the panel.
"Stand clear of the platform. Stand clear of the yellow line."
The nested rings started to spin with a metallic rasp. Then the two inner rings rotated on their axis until they were horizontal, leaving a dark blue glow in their wake. A moment later, the innermost ring rotated along the second ring's axis, creating a third axis. The rings started to hum as the dark blue energy obscured the inside of the transit platform. Finally, the first ring stopped, with a rune glowing. The horizontal ring slowed to a stop a few seconds later, a different rune glowing over our heads at the spot where it intersected with the third ring. Finally, the innermost ring stopped, and I could see the glow of a rune at the top of the rings. The glow pulsed brighter for a moment, then disappeared completely, revealing an empty platform. Dee gave a squeal of delight as the rings slowly started to return to their original.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.